Historical fiction was one of my favorite types of genre.
Historical fiction for me was one of my favorites also, but I didn't really mind nonfiction or fiction. I just really liked the books that like kept you wanting to like read more and wanting to know more about it and like not wanting to put it down.
The first one that I read, I can't remember the name exactly, but I think it was the Washington Red Sox, S-O-C-K-S. There were four children. It was like a mystery, and it was all about like going in a canoe in the middle of the night, and all of a sudden they wake up in the middle of a Revolutionary War, like walking with the soldiers, and it was just really interesting because the kids were telling the story. It wasn't an adult. It wasn't like a documentary. It was like something that I really liked.
And one of my favorite books was the most recent book I just read was, it was called London Calling. And I loved it because it like, well, for me, it made me feel like I was really there during that time with like the descriptive words that he put in and like how like they traveled back. And it wasn't exactly like from like a soldier or a general, that point of view. It was from a different like work-based parent and child and how they were going through the war. And like, it was just like a small town and everything. It wasn't anything major.
I had to do a report on Anne Frank and I had to read the Diary of Anne Frank, like a book report. And I was really interested and I had to do a whole like physical display with like the Star of David and making all like the little things that were like important to her life in like the fifth grade. And so I just got really interested in the Holocaust and my mom kept on like buying me more books. I know in my house I currently probably have about 6 to 7 books on the Holocaust that I like to read every once in a while again because it's just really interesting and it like makes you think, oh, what if I was there then?
I enjoy reading fiction and nonfiction, so I don't really have a favorite. Like, if you give me something I'll say, oh yes, that definitely looks interesting. I'll read that. If you give me Anne Frank's diary, I'll say, oh, that looks very interesting. Or Under a War-Torn Sky, I'll say, oh, that I want to read that. Or something different. I don't have a favorite.
Like, you know, it really depends on the book for me. I like to read. You know, generally, I'm not really into science fiction. And I don't really like the super cheesy, you know, like so stereotypical kind of like romance novels or whatever. But, you know, it really just depends on the book for me. You know, some books, you just have to read them and you might be surprised.
I have a personal experience, actually. In English class, we read The Telltale Heart by Edgar Allan Poe. And I found that fascinating. I love that. And so I decided to go to the library and check out a book of all of his poems. And I sat there and I read his poems and I loved them all. I just didn't even know I liked his style of the more horror and suspense, scary, eerie kind of books, but I found out that I did.
And I have to say, I definitely think, because my mom reads a lot and she reads pretty hard books, and also just more specific, she really likes murder mysteries, and you know, a lot of people are like, why do you read murder mysteries? And it's like, well, you know, my mom has them around the house and I think they're really good, so I kind of picked up that from her too.
Fever, 1793, I found was very dramatic. There was a lot of sad kind of things you could cry about, things that were scary, families throwing out their own family members out of the windows because they thought that they could contaminate them, even though they were dead. I found that reading Fever really gave me a different perspective on human beings themselves and history itself and how it's really this huge dramatic story that we can all relate to in some way, shape, or form.
One book that I really liked and I could connect to a lot and I learned a lot from, it was a book about World War I called War Horse. And it was all from the perspective of a horse, so that kind of gave you new insight on like people themselves and how some weird traits people have, and it was just really different and helped you learn about history. Even though it wasn't real, you could kind of connect to it in other ways. I didn't understand everything, so I felt like I needed to learn more about it. So after that, I read some nonfiction books and learned more. A thing I really enjoyed is when you connect things from class to class, like you're reading a novel about World War II in English, and then you're learning about it in history, you feel like you can kind of learn that way better when everything's connected instead of just going from one completely different thing to another completely different thing between classes. It just really helps when everything's connected.